Nerves are always going to be there, but controlling them and overcoming them, that is the goal, my friend. What's going on, guys? This is not your ordinary guy. No. This is your motivation guy. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. And today, we're going to be going over some tips and tricks to help you avoid choking in fights while playing Fortnite. And if you're like me, you know, I used to get nervous all the times in fights, you know, even though I played, you know, so many hours. So that's why we wanted to bring you this video today, because I truly, truly understand, man, what you guys are going through. First thing that you need to remember is that it's a natural thing to be nervous. It really, really is. This is your instincts kicking in, and it really doesn't matter if you're a top tier player or just somebody who has just started out. Being nervous, guys, man, it's a part of just being human, all right? So stop being so hard on yourself. You know, stop saying that you're not good enough, because you get anxious sometimes, you get nervous sometimes, man. It's just a part of being human, right? It's healthy and competitive sport, and Fortnite is really no exception. I mean, come on, man. Like, you dropped into a match with 100 players, and you fought so hard to stay alive. And when you get down to the last 30, the last 20, I mean, the last 10 players, nerves are gonna kick in. So in today's video, we're gonna help you guys control your emotional and your mental state so that you're gonna get that sweet victory royale and you're going to start seeing a turnaround in your gameplay. But before we get into anything, I want to say this, my friends. I know a lot of you guys are watching these videos without subscribing. So please remember, guys, to sub if you haven't already, because once we hit 1 million subscribers, we're going to do a story on myself, your motivation guy, Keith Allen. And I know we're going to get there soon, man. So please subscribe. Connect with me on my Instagram as well. I love to connect with you guys. Listen, you guys are part of the Bunch of Crunch Army. You know what I mean? If you're a part of the Bunch of Crunch Army, that means, man, we inspire people every single day. We motivate people every single day. When we wake up, we think about the people who we can impact. And that's what I want you to do. All right. Look to make a difference in your family. Look to make a difference with your friends. Look to make a difference on anybody who you come in contact with, or who you talk to, or who you play with. All right. Be that person and make that change. All right, guys, it's about that time. Ladies and gentlemen around the world, it's time to scream this out. It's time to sit back, relax, and grab some of my favorite candy. What is that, y'all? It's that Bunch of Crunch. And let's get this going. Our first tip is to identify what makes you so nervous. You know, being able to understand what makes you nervous is a massive step in being able to control and overcome the nerves, okay? Think back at the games that you played this week. What made you nervous? Was it the time the Dark Bomber skin build battled you and won and then you took the L? Or was it that arena late game and you didn't know how to properly rotate? Let's be honest, my friends. Like, I've been there a whole lot of times. I know more than anybody, man. So, you know, about being nervous, we've all been nervous at some point or another. So let's take the first example, that Dark Bomber build battle. Okay, so if this encounter made you nervous, then playing normal public matches isn't for you right now. Don't get me wrong, it's gonna help, you know, the more experience you have online, but to be honest, that's not the most effective training that you can do. If it's build battles that make you nervous, then finding a good player to fight in creative 1v1s is the best thing for you to do, okay? So if you don't know any good players, you can check out our community Discord, which is linked in the description. And that server there are the channels dedicated to creative 1v1s. Looking further than the players you already play with is gonna give you guys the experience of different play styles. So the more and more you participate in these type of fights, the better that you're gonna react in the game. So what about, you know, if you get nervous in the late game? Oof, who gets nervous in late game? Come on now, let's be honest. Once again, Discord servers are your best bet, okay? Depending on, you know, where you're from, there should be an open scrim Discord which hosts custom code matches. They are normally hosted every single day, so consistent practice is available. And the more and more that you play in the custom games, really the less nervous that you're gonna become. So as you can see from these two examples, depending on what makes you nervous, there is a solution to it. That is the good news. So I want you to think back, guys, to a time where you were nervous about something. Maybe it was the first time you drove a car, or maybe the first time you rode a bike. Maybe the first time you went swimming. Now think how easy it is right now. The first time that you do something, you know, it's really normal to be nervous. In fact, I don't think there's been a time in my life that I wasn't nervous about something. But the thing is that you can't let it stop you. That's right, you can't let it stop you. It's really healthy, you know, in this fight against nerves, you know, so that we become our own motivators and we don't let our lives get controlled by fear. So ensuring that we are effectively overcoming our nerves is really important for our development. So let's talk about more ways to actually overcome nerves in Fortnite. Here we go. So if you do struggle pinpointing your weaknesses, then check out Play With Pros, our service, which gives you guys access to a wide range of pro players with the goal of improving any aspect of your gameplay. Check out the link in the description, okay? So our next tip, guys, is stress testing. So what do we mean by stress test? Well, by stress test, we mean put yourself in as many stressful situations as you can. Have you ever watched pro players like Mr. Savage avoid dying in crazy situations like having a full squad spray him down? He can do this because he plays the game so much, man, and he really purposely puts himself in these situations to test his abilities. So a lot of players get stressed and nervous when they are put in certain situations that isn't really the norm for them, right? And that's why we recommend actively seeking these situations, because eventually you're gonna get comfortable, man. You really are. So we know the goal in Fortnite is to win, as that's obviously the general goal in any battle royale. But if you're constantly playing it safe, if you're constantly boxing up, you know, if you're bush camping, if you're avoiding encounters, then, you know, you're only delaying your own improvement. So the bush camper is likely to be a worse player than the WKer. Not because the bush camper is a bad player, purely just because the fact that the WKer is just actively putting himself in high stress situations all the time, which really require him to, over time, is gonna be more calm and he's gonna have more constructive thinking, right? So if you start a fight with somebody who's camped in a bush the entire game, it's really, really likely that they're not gonna be good in this situation. So what are some of the best ways to seek out these high stress situations? Really good question. Here we go. The best ways to put yourself in these situations are, firstly, playing game modes that don't have, you know, a point system. We're referring to arena mode or tournaments, pretty much any competitive playlist, all right? Now, this does seem counterproductive because you may want to overcome your nervousness when in a competitive scene, but you can't expect to go into a competitive game mode and not get nervous. As we said earlier, being nervous is something that you really can't cancel out and you really can't ignore. Nerves are always going to be there, but controlling them and overcoming them, that is the goal, my friends. And I believe in you, and I know this is your year where you're going to get breakthrough at overcoming your fear and overcoming the anxiety and overcoming all the nerves, all right? Who believes that? You gotta believe it first, come on. So learning to control your nerves, man, you should go into public playlists like solos, all right? Duos and even squads, where even though you are affecting your stats in game, they're not a massive deal compared to your arena points. So don't be a player who cares about their stats so much that they avoid fights just to ensure their KD stays high. Let's take a look at our final point, which is talking about the right mindset to have. So important, man. So having the proper mindset in place, that's gonna help you guys like relieve a lot of fear. It's gonna help you relieve and overcome nervousness and anxiety that you may be feeling towards Fortnite. So when you're nervous, you don't really think straight, right? You're gonna mess up shots, you're gonna mess up builds. I mean, your editing is gonna be jacked up. And these are really the fundamentals of Fortnite. So there's clearly a problem here. So a proper mindset is gonna help you control and help you overcome a lot of emotions, all right? So let's dive into this first mindset. So important. The first mindset that you want to adapt to is that, you know, this game is always going to be here. Yeah. Some of you guys may need a reminder that the game will still be here after your next loss and the loss after that. Yeah, we never want to lose. I get it. But we also need to be able to control our emotions, and having this reminder can keep your emotions in check, right? If knowing that the game that you're in would not be your last, then that should help ease a lot of these negative feelings that we have when we're playing. Because once you're eliminated, yo, reload, let's do it. So the second mindset is really kind of a controversial one. It's the mindset of, it's just a game. Now, I know a lot of people disagree with this mindset. One of the biggest faces in gaming history, my boy Ninja, tweeted about this. I'm going to read it to you because, to be honest, I couldn't have put it better myself. He tweeted, "The phrase, it's just a game, is such a weak mindset. You are okay with what happened, losing, imperfection of a craft. When you stop getting angry after losing, you've lost twice. There's always something to learn, always room for improvement. Never settle. So we want you guys to know that we're not just promoting the mindset, it's just a game, because we agree with Ninja. If you think it's just a game, you're not gonna put everything into, you know, perfecting your gameplay, and there's not gonna be really any competitive drive in you. So I get that. Having a competitive drive is a key aspect of improving in Fortnite and in life, my friends. A lot of people are motivated and they're gonna grind for longer and work harder if they think someone else out there is working harder than them. So the drive to be the best player is what gets you to the top. You don't think Booga went to the World Cup looking to play second or third, right? So that's everything, my friends, that is gonna help you guys choke less in Fortnite. So before the video ends, your boy has to do a recap. Here we go. So figuring out what makes you nervous so that you can effectively train and improve at these aspects, I'm telling you guys, you're gonna see improvement over time if you guys invest in yourself, okay? Stress test, woo, stress test. Can we take some stress tests today? Let's do it. It's all about putting yourself in these intense, high stress situations where you can get used to. This is gonna help you choke less by being experienced in this aspect, right? So having the proper mindset in place is gonna allow some breathing room for your anxiety, knowing that this isn't the last game. That's right. Once you're eliminated, man, it's time to reboot. It's time to get back in this thing. All right, guys, once again, this is your motivation guy. That's right, the one who believes in you. Man, the one who loves you, man. The one who is just honestly just rooting for you guys. Like, purely, like, without motive, man, I really just want you guys to succeed, not only in this game, but also in life. And, man, I know one of these days, we're going to be doing a story on one of you guys, man. I'm telling you. So keep going, man. Your dreams will come true if you don't give up. And let's make it happen, man. Thank you for watching it. And also just, you know, honestly, liking the video, subscribing to the channel if you haven't already, because we got so much great stuff coming out on this Pro Guys Fortnite channel, man. We'll see you guys soon. Your motivation guy. Peace.